tricks we can do? Let's see. I brought all this right here. Some other props. Let's try this one here. Yes. Okay.
Thank you for trying.
Oh, we know this
Auto
one. I'm just gonna skip this. The world's
perfect for magicians with low intelligence.
For this trick, you will need two props.
Okay.
One is a square of thin blue fabric.
And second, a yellow bandana. Pick up the bandana. Now, fold the bandana in half. That's right, fold it in half. Now, fold it one more time. Take the folded bandana and hide it in your left hand. Remember to keep your hand in a natural position. This is called palming. Now that you've mastered palming, open up the folded bandana. Show the audience that it's a regular bandana by waving it up and down. If an audience member doesn't believe it's a normal bandana, allow him to wipe his face on it. Now pick up the square piece of fabric and gather the four corners together, making a little makeshift bag. Using your free hand, fold the bandana along the creases you've made earlier and drop it into the folds of that makeshift bag. From the outside of the makeshift bag, squeeze the bandana into a small little ball. What the audience didn't see is that you never put the bandana in the fabric at all. You really kept it hidden in your left hand. Remember palming? Again, remember to keep your left hand held naturally. Just relax and look natural. And for the grand finish, flip open the fabric and receive your well-deserved applause.
I feel happy. Thank you. sitting here with Steve, I'm going to have you swallow this sword. Now tell me, have you ever swallowed a sword?
No.
Then this will be neat, won't it? Yes. Now I'm going to show all of you how much fun it is to swallow a sword by introducing you all to a friend of mine who is an expert sword swallower. Here he is, Jim, the sword swallowing chicken. Now we will have Jim swallow the sword to show you how to do it. But first, I will hypnotize Jim. Jim! Sleep! He is asleep. Now, he will swallow that sword. But you will notice. That was a little rude, wasn't it? As he swallows the sword, to show you how much fun you will have, he will joyously tap dance at the same time. Grown man making his living this way, Steve. What do you do for a living?
Executive security.
I don't have a joke for that. All right. Watch the little toes. It's not a real chicken. In just a second, that will happen to you. Unfortunately, it killed Jim. You're next. Steve, stand right there on that spot. You didn't do that, did you? No. All right. Hands at your side, face front. Because I'm going to have you swallow this differently. I'm not going to have you swallow it from top to bottom. I'm going to have you swallow it side to side. Oh, oh, when I say three, I'm going to drive the sword right through his head. Beating a little quicker here. I don't want to upset you. I brought this with me. This little set of wooden stocks. Now, in just a second, I'm going to place your head in there. Then I take the sword, run it through. Nothing gets hurt on the inside. Tell me, have you ever done this trick before?
No.
Oh, me neither. I got this on eBay. This will be neat. Now, chin up. A perfect fit. And in it goes. Now, you'll notice there are two handles, Steve. There's one for your left hand and one for your right. Oh, you're nervous. Your skin's leaking. All right. Then the other side. Hold tightly. That keeps the head from rolling. Now we change places. Turn back this way and about two steps back. Under the bag. Okay, good. Now, first of all, be honest. Do you feel this?
Yes.
Oh. No, do you really? Well, you shouldn't. I got it. Okay, before I do this thing, I have one question for you, Steve. Do you moose that? Now, normally we don't allow flash photography during the show, but this is a special dispensation. If you brought a camera with you, this is the Kodak moment. For you, a kaopectate moment. Right? Keep your chin against the board, or this will hurt a lot. I'll do it slow. One, two, three. Turn this way a little bit. Reach. Turn around, turn all the way around. Watch around. No, hold your applause. Stuck there, Steve. Matter of fact, they're stuck here too. So I'd like to take this brief opportunity to talk to you all about Amway products. Take a deep swallow. Good. And let's give the young man a big
round of applause. Richard Ross, Holland.
Thank you. Every time it rains pennies from heaven. And don't you know each cloud contains pennies from heaven?
You'll find your fortune falling all over the town. Be sure that your umbrella is upside down.
And trade them for a package of sunshine and some flowers. If you want the things you love, you must have showers.
So when you hear it thunder, don't run under a tree.
There'll be pennies from heaven for you.
For you and me.
Every time it rains pennies from heaven. Don't you know each cloud contains pennies from heaven?
Trade them for a package of sunshine and flower. If you want the things you love, you gotta have showers.
Time it rains pennies from heaven.
Don't you know that each cloud contains pennies from heaven?
You'll find your fortunes falling all over the town.
Be sure that your umbrella is upside down.
Trade them for a package of sunshine and flowers.
If you want the things you love, you gotta have showers.
So when you hear it thunder, don't run under a tree. There'll be pennies from heaven for you and me.
Say to me, Ed, where should we sit so we can see all the tricks? Well, in this nice theater and at home, all of the seats are fantastic, but I have to admit, I do have a favorite right over here. This is what I would call the best seat in the house. One problem, though, it's already occupied. I'd like to find a gentleman from the audience. Woohoo! Let's see. How about you? Would you help? Come on up here. Yeah. Can you give him a round of applause? Here's a gentleman. Wow, thanks for dressing up. You look awesome. Maybe I'm overdressed. What's your name?
Jaren.
Jaren. That's a cool name. Jaren, tuck everything in so you look nice and proper on television. Could you? I'll block in case your stomach hangs out or anything. Ta-da! It's like a quick change artist, isn't he? You look fantastic now. Yes. Yeah. 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 I'm going to show you why, because I have something for you. Oh, yes. And it's right back there. No, 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 not her. That's Kanoe. the plastic wrap. Let me show you how it works. Kanoe's going to stand here against this wooden post, and right here, some plastic like you might wrap packages in when you go to ship them. I'm going to hand this to you, and then bring it around the backside right over to me. That's perfect. I'm going to hand it back to you again. And we're going to go round and round. See the idea? There we go. We'll just meet each other halfway. Oh, this is fun. All right. Now hold it right there. Let's trim away the excess. Perfect. Ah, and now I need you to make sure that she's really sealed in on the backside. Check everything. And come on over here. All right. Now what you're about to see is clearly impossible. Check this out. You ready, sir? Here we go. Oh, you know what? Step inside and make sure that she can't get out of there. One, two, three, drop the curtain.
Dalla Romania, in rappresentanza della Farber Production, il duo Romance.
Who, to my surprise, were not even from France.
These costumes are crazy. I need to join you girls. I need a feather. That's better, right?
Beautiful.
It's not quite as flamboyant as you guys, but it's a start. It's a start. Let me have a look.
Wait,
wait. Oh, it's all right. Go, yeah, Let me show you something strange, actually. As you can see, if you get the angle, right, with the feather, you can almost make it look like the feather with the reflection goes right through the mirror. Tell you what.
Definitely pull it through the mirror.
Oh no.
Oh.
Oh.
No.
I don't know what's happening.
Nothing there.
It looks just like a can-can feather.
And it's not even bent, so he couldn't.
That's the thing.
He couldn't have like balled it in his hand or anything. Like,
he really did it. He put a feather through a mirror.
Yeah, that's crazy.
I'm going to be a little bit creative today, and I'm going to be using a lady's head under this bucket right here. Your job, audience, is to keep your eye on Chantel's head. Now, I want you all to imagine that you are in Vegas. We're going to make it easy for you. We're going to keep her head right here in the middle to start the trick. All you have to do is keep your eye on Chantel. Watch carefully as we shuffle the buckets. Ah! Alright, nobody knows where the lady is as we shuffle her around. Now we have three buckets. We have this one. We have the middle. Now we have that one. Audience, I want you to gamble here. I want you to guess where she is. Where do you think the lady is? Is she under this one? Is she in the middle? Is she under that one? Alright, you think she's under this one? She is not under this one. Do you think she's in the middle? You're right, she's not in the middle. She's in fact right here under that one. Alright, we're going to make it easy for you. We're always going to start with her head right here in the middle. That way you can keep a better eye. Shuffle around nice and quickly. Are there any gamblers in the audience? Anyone feeling lucky? Have a bit of a guess, this one, the middle, or that one? This one? No, she's not there. Where do you think she is, middle or that one? You think she's under the middle? No, she's not under the middle. You've got to pay attention, she's right here under that one. I tell you what, I'm going to give you one more chance. Should we make it a little bit easier for you? We're going to make it super duper easy for everyone today by giving you three ladies' heads to work with. This way you cannot go wrong. We have one lady's head right here under this one. We have a second lady's head right here in the middle. And we have a third and final lady's head right here under that one. There you go. You can't get this wrong. There's three ladies' heads. You should be able to keep your eye on it. Here you go. Shuffle it around.
She's not!
dance now. You don't have to be beautiful to turn me on. I just need your body, baby, from dusk till dawn. You don't have to be rich to be my girl. You don't have to be cool to rule my world. Ain't no particular sign I'm more compatible with. I just want your extra time and your kiss. Think I better dance now.